press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello students, so today let us start a new chapter, that is constructions. So in the lower class you have studied so many constructions, like in the basic you have studied how to construct the triangle and line segment, means just to draw a line segment. And as you come for the higher classes, you have studied in 9th standard, you have studied how to draw the perpendicular bisector for the angle given, and also the angles you have constructed of various degrees, isn't it, last year. And also so many constructions you have studied, bisecting an angle, given angle you have studied, isn't it. So here in this 10th standard you are going to study three main concepts. One is division of a line segment, that is division of a line segment. So we have to divide the line segment in the given ratio. So they will give the ratio in the form of, like, general form it is m is to n form. So you can, so there they will give 2 is to 3, or 3 is to 5, or 5 is to 2, like that they will give the ratio. You have to divide the line segment according to the ratio given, okay. And the next one, you have to construct a triangle, similar triangle, that is second one, okay. So first one is division of a line segment, and the second one is you have to construct a triangle, that is similar triangle. To construct a triangle similar to the given triangle as per the given scale factor. Here scale factor means corresponding sides they will give. So according to the scale factor they will give the ratio, accordingly you have to construct a similar triangle of the given triangle. Now by now you all know what are similar triangles, okay. In that you have to study two types, okay, that I am going to show when I am constructing the triangles. And the third concept is construction of a tangent to a circle. So you have to construct a tangent to a circle. Now also you know what are tangents. See, in the chapter circles you have done the tangents. So you have to study, in this chapter you are going to study how to construct the tangent to the given circle. So these are the three main concepts which you are going to study, and definitely you people should have your geometry box with you, so that it is easy to do it along with me only, okay. Otherwise you won't understand. So simply if you sit and glance you won't understand. So please try to work out, try to do it along with me only. And here the main thing, whenever you do the constructions you have to write the steps of construction. So steps of constructions are very very important, and also you have to give the justification for those, means okay, what I have done is correct. So you have to prove that. That is called justification. These two things are very very important, okay. So let me try. So what I feel, that is construction, steps of construction, you please write by looking at the textbook. You are having one examples over there. So I hope you can write the construction. Now let me start with the division of a line segment. So division of a line segment, so the line segment is given, a certain measurement they will give, and they will give the ratio also. So you have to divide that line segment in the given ratio, okay. Now for the first one, to divide the line segment in the given ratio, so this is side heading, to divide a line segment in a given ratio. So now let us take, see, another thing which is important thing which I have to tell you is, so if you are doing, like if I say that draw a line segment of 6 cm in your book, but I can't draw a 6 cm here on the board because 6 cm will be too small for you. So I'm taking the scale. Suppose if I ask you to take 6 cm, I'm going to take 12 cm here. Okay, is it clear? Okay, so let us start the first one, that is to divide a line segment in the given ratio. Now I'll take one example, that is exercise first, in that exercise 11.1. so the first one you can try out. So I'm going to take one example now, so you can write the question there. So draw a line segment. So I'll write here, draw a line segment of length 8 cm and divide it in the ratio 3:2. Okay, 3:2. This is the question. Okay, now let us start. Now for that, first you need to draw a line segment of, so I'm going to use this part to draw the line segment, to draw construct, and this part to write justification and all. So here draw a line segment of length 8 cm. So I'm going to take here 8 cm. So in my scale it will be more than that, that is into 4 times I will take extra. Okay, then I have to draw a, so this is AB. First step, draw a line segment AB which is equal to 8 cm. Okay, that is the first step. So draw, this is steps of construction. Draw, step 1, draw a line segment. You can write in your own words, AB is equal to 8 cm. Then I'll just take an acute angle here, any measurement. So it's not that you need a particular measurement. You can take an acute angle here. Okay. Draw an acute angle. So let it be X here, acute angle. So step 2, draw a ray AX making an acute angle with AB, okay, this is an acute angle. Then let us take the compass. Now here, just see here, 3:2. So I'll add this 3:2, that is 5, 3 plus 2 is 5. So I am going to divide this ray, that is AX, into five parts, five equal parts. Okay, five equal parts. So you need not take any particular measurement. You just take five equal parts. Okay, so from here, 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll extend this. You can extend, okay, without changing the radius. You have to draw five parts, five equal parts, and here you can mention A1, A2, A3, A4, and A5. So what is the next step? So you can write in your own notes. So locate or mark five, that is 3 + 2, 5 points or 5 arcs, you can say 5 points, A1, A2, A3, A4 and A5 on ray AX, such that, so this is X for us, such that, so what is the condition? A1 is equal to A1, A2 is equal to A2, A3 is equal to A3, A4 is equal to A4, A5. I hope you understood this. So the next very important procedure now. Now I am going to draw this. I'll join A5. See, this is our A5 here. A5 and B. So the next step is join. Fourth step, join A5, B. So I have joined A5, B. Is it clear? So now it's a very, very important. You have to draw, please note, you have to draw a parallel line for A5, B. Okay, A5, B, a parallel line for A5, B. Where you have to draw, see, it is divided in 3:2. So you take this point 3, A3, and you have to draw a parallel line for A5, B. See, like this, it should be parallel. Okay, and you all know how to draw a parallel line. So I'll do it. See, just observe carefully, it's a very, very important. So you keep at A5 and mark an arc here like this with same radius. Go to A3, mark arc like this. Okay, then measure this angle here. Now just see this, measure this angle with the same radius. You cut an arc on this. Okay, I hope you understood. First, what I did from A5, I draw one arc like this with the same radius without changing. I keep it on A3 and mark an arc like this. Then this angle, I am going to measure this angle. Same angle, I am going to cut the arc here. Then the next step, you are going to join this. Here A3 and this, and you are going to extend it such that it meets here, that is point C. It meets AB at C. So now AC is to CB will be 3:2 ratio. See, because 1, 2, 3, so 3:2. See, isn't it easy? Definitely. Okay, now I'll complete the steps of construction. Now what I did, I join B, A, 5. Next. Fifth one. Draw a line. Draw a line parallel to B, A, 5. Draw a line parallel to B, A, 5. Such that it meets or it intersects AB at C. Therefore, AC is to CB is equal to 3:2. 3:2, like that. So, I hope you understood now. Now, we will do the justification. So, this is a very important, I told you now, justification. Now, I hope you understood the steps and also the construction. Okay. Now, justification, shall I do it here? Justification. See, we all know we have drawn parallel. Therefore, A5B is parallel to A3C. Correct? A5B is parallel to A3C. Now, when two lines are parallel, by BPT you might have studied when two lines are parallel. So, okay. So, in triangle, please write. In triangle. So, in triangle. So, here there are two triangles. One is AB A5. See, one triangle is AB A5 and the other triangle is AC A3. Okay, we have A5B parallel to A3B. Is it clear? Now, can we write this AB by AC is equal to AA5 by AA3 is equal to BA5 by CA3. Isn't it? By BPT. Basic proportionality theorem. I hope you can recall this by BPT. Suppose if two lines are parallel, means here, CA3 is parallel to, means a line drawn which is parallel to the third side of a triangle will cut or it will divide the other two lines in equal proportion or with equal ratios. So here I wrote AB by AC is equal to AA5 by A3. Now, as you all know, AA3 is how much? How many parts? 1, 2, 3. So, AA3, AA5 is how many parts? AA5 is equal to 3 by 2. AA5 means here AA5 is 5 divided by AA3 is 3. So, here okay, now, okay, here, this is also correct, or shall we write this? Okay, if it is parallel, so can I write this as AC by CB is equal to AA3 by A3A5. So A3 is how much? 3. A3, 5 is 2. So it is in the ratio 3 is to 2. So this is justification. Okay. Now, with the same knowledge, how we did this to divide the line segment, we can also construct the similar triangles, which I am going to show it now. So you followed the step construction. So now next one, to construct a triangle, to divide the line segment, you have another method in your textbook also, but I followed this method because that knowledge can be utilized here to construct the similar triangles. So because of that, I followed this method. Okay, you can do any method, whichever you are convenient. To construct a triangle, similar to a given triangle. As per given scale factor. See, scale factor will be given, you have to construct the similar triangle. So for that, so I am going to do the 11.2, exercise 11.2, second one. So I will read out the question for you. Construct a triangle of the sides 4 centimeter, 5 centimeter and 6 centimeter, and then a triangle similar to this whose sides are 2 by 3 of the corresponding sides of the first triangle. See here, the scale factor here in this question, the scale factor is, see, they have given the ratio, that is 2 by 3. 2 by 3 is the scale factor. 2 by 3 is the scale factor here. Now I told you at the beginning, in the introduction, that is, there are two types, that is, one is 2 by 3 factor, one means here, see, when you construct the triangle here, similar triangles, we will get another triangle which will be, inside this, you will get a triangle inside this. Suppose if it is in the improper, that is 5 by 3 means than the required triangle, see, this is the original triangle, you will get the triangle which is bigger than this. So there are two types of triangles you will get. One is like 2 by 3, see here, and it's improper fraction, here proper fraction, correct? So when you do this, you will get a triangle which is smaller than the given triangle. But when we construct the similar triangle for this, definitely it will be bigger than the given triangle. So that I am going to tell you when I construct here. So first let me show how to construct. So here they have asked you to construct a triangle with 4 cm, 5 cm and 6 cm as the side, correct? 4, 5 and 6. So I am going to take a triangle of base 6 centimeter. Now this is AB. Then, so I am from the scale, I am going to construct 4 centimeter on side, 6 centimeter, 4 and 5. Okay. So now I am going to take 4. You know how to construct a triangle? Okay, let me take a little bigger one. Six. Four. See, you know how to construct 4 centimeter, then 5 centimeter. Okay, now let me join this. Okay, then so this is now for us ABC is a given triangle. So they have asked us to construct a triangle ABC such that AB is equal to 6 centimeter and this is 4 centimeter and this is 5 centimeter. This is the first step what you have to do. Next, here I'll draw again as we did for the line segment, the same way I'll draw a line, a ray such that it makes an acute angle with AB. Okay, acute angle with AB. Now, so next I'm going to divide this into three parts. Here I'm going to take the greater number here among 2 and 3. Which is greater? 3. 3 is greater. So I'm going to take 3 and I'll divide. So here, but for the line segment, I hope you can understand. There what we did, we added this ratio. But now here I'm going to take this 3 and I'm going to divide this line segment into 3 parts. 1, 2 and 3. Okay. Now here I'm going to write this as A1, A2 and A3. A1, A2 and A3. Now what I'll do, I am going to join this A3 and B, A3 and B, same way. I am going to join this A3 and B. What is the next step? Next step is, see, again I have to draw a parallel line, from A2, see here like this, from A2. Why from A2? Because here 2 is there. So we have to draw from the second part, that is A1, A2. From here, I am going to draw A2 here. Means this line, this AB will be divided into 2:1 ratio. Okay, 2:1 ratio. Understood? So for that, as usual, I told you. So what I have to do? I will just draw an arc here. Okay, same way I'll keep here and with the same radius I'm going to cut the arc here. Okay, then I'm going to measure this angle here. So with the same measurement, so this arc I have to extend now. Okay, now what I'll do, I'll try to join this. See here, this, like this. What I did, from A2 I have joined this. So this will be our B1 or B dash. Okay, B dash. Now what I have to do, again I have to draw another parallel line for BC. So I have to draw another parallel line BC like this. See, parallel line to BC. Okay, for that again I have to do the same procedure. You have to follow the same procedure. From B you just mark an arc like this, and from this point where B dash, see B dash I have told you when we draw a parallel, that is A to B dash, that will intersect AB at B dash. So here, from here, I am going to mark this again. Next, from here, so this is an arc, and I am going to draw an arc like this. Next, I am going to draw a parallel line here. See here, I have drawn a parallel line. Now, so this will be our C dash. I don't know, I hope you are not confused. See here, where I am shading here. So this is a triangle. No need to shade, but I am just showing it so that for your reference, that's all. So here I will draw this, and this is a required triangle, similar triangle to ABC. So which is the required triangle? You have to write here A, B dash, C dash is the required triangle. See, I hope you understood this. So let me tell the procedure once again. Construction, steps of construction. So you have in your book also, please refer that. First, what I did, I'll just explain. Construct a triangle ABC, okay, with 6 cm, AB is equal to 6 cm, AC is equal to 4 cm and BC is equal to 5 cm. Then, I draw a ray AX such that it makes acute angle with AB. Next, I located the point A1, A2, A3. Okay, such that AA1 is equal to AA2 is equal to AA3. Next, what I did, I joined A3B. Next, I draw the parallel line for A3B. Okay, A3B, parallel line from A2, and that line it intersect AB at B dash. Next, what I did, I draw a parallel line to BC. So B dash, C dash is a parallel line again, and that will meet AC at C dash. So that line will meet AC at C dash. Now then B dash and C dash is the required triangle. Then how to do justification? Justification. See, justification is very, very important. Now, in triangle AA3B means the down part in this triangle. So you all know A2B dash is parallel to A3B, okay? So these two lines are parallel. So when these two lines are parallel, you all know that the two triangles are similar. The two triangles are similar. Okay, now triangle, so in this case triangle AB dash A2 is similar to triangle AB A3. I hope you understood the down, I am talking about the here below this AB, line AB, there are two triangles, that is AB dash A2, AB, AB, A3. Now, when these two triangles are similar, can I write like this? So, by BPT, here corresponding CPST, because two triangles are similar, I have written this. Okay, same way in triangle ACB, here also, so both these two lines are parallel. So, B dash C dash is equal to, parallel to BC. So, this line is parallel to this line, that is BC is parallel to B dash C dash. Next, therefore, you all know triangle ACB is similar to triangle ACB is similar to triangle AC dash B dash. Therefore, AC by AC dash is equal to CB by C dash B dash is equal to AB by AB dash. Okay. Now, just observe from here. AB dash and AB. AB is how much? AB is how much? AB is 3. A dash, B dash, AB dash. See, this is how much? 2. And how much is this? 3. 2. Correct? So, here AB by A dash B is 3. Now, so can we write that all the corresponding sides, that is here AB dash is how much? AB dash by AB is, AB dash by AB is 2 by 3. So, this is the reciprocal. Okay. So, AB dash by AB is 2 by 3. Same way, this side equal, and AC by C dash C, AC by C dash C is also how much? AC. Again, here all the 3, I mean all you are getting as 2 is to 3. See here. So, can we say that all this is equal to, all this AB dash is equal to 2 by 3, 2 by 3, 2 by 3. So, the corresponding sides are proportion. See, the corresponding, see, AB dash by B dash B is equal to 3 is to 1. That is, 2 is to 1 or 2 is to 3. Same way, this also 3 is to 2. Same way, all. Okay. I hope you understood. So, this is the justification of the triangle construction. So, I hope you followed. Please write the construction, steps of construction also. Thank you. Have a nice day. So, in the next class, I am going to teach the other construction. Thank you.